Welcome to this prayer. This is prayer for the new month, the month of June. We have 5 minutes more before the end of this month of May. 5 minutes more before the month of May ends. So we are entering in the new month in the presence of God. So we are privileged, we are blessed. We are blessed to be in the presence of God and to enter into the new month while in the presence of God. This is an amazing thing. We are thanking the Lord Almighty who has made it possible for us to come to the end of this month of May, the end of May. We are just very close to the end of the month of May. It is by the grace of God that we have this privilege of seeing the end of this month. So we are thanking the Lord, apart from praying for his blessing on the month of June. We are also grateful to God Almighty that He has brought us thus far. Okay, so let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us in the Son and the Lord of this. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Righteous Father, thank you, thank you. We thank you for this wonderful opportunity you've given to us to be in your presence. Father, thank you for this session, this night session, Lord. Thank you, Father Almighty, that we are crossing over from the month of May into the month of June in your presence, for the opportunity and privilege, O Lord, of accessing your presence today, Lord, and of entering the new month in your very presence, Lord. Father, we thank you, we worship you. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Everybody, open your mouth now and begin to thank God. I want you to thank the Lord. To be thanking the Lord while we step into the new month. Let this new month meet you while you are thanking God, where you are appreciating Him for all the things He's done for you in the month of May. All the blessings, all the favors, all the opportunities, all the things that you see around you that the Lord has done for you. Just open your mouth and begin to glorify His name. Praise Him and adore Him. Say, Lord, may your name be glorified. Father, thank you for the opportunity. Thank you, Lord Almighty. I am so grateful, Lord. We are grateful. Lord, we are so grateful. We bless you, Lord. We magnify your holy name. Be glorified. Be lifted up, God. Thank you, Father, for all the love, for all the care, for the protection, for the favors, for the opportunities and everything. We are so, so grateful. Let the Lord know how grateful you are to have received these favors from Him. Father, we are so grateful. Thank you. May your name be glorified in the name of Jesus. May your name be lifted up, God. Thank you for good health. Thank you, Lord Almighty, for so many blessings to be given to us. We cannot mention them. They are too numerous to mention. They are too numerous to count. But we are so grateful, Lord. Our hearts, O Lord, are full of gratitude. Our hearts are full of gratitude, Lord, for the blessings and for the favors. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Father, there is none like you in heaven and on earth and everywhere. You are worthy of praise, Lord. We join the angels and the saints and adoring you and lifting you up and blessing you and magnifying you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Congratulations to you as we step into the month of June. Welcome to this month. Happy new month to you. And good morning to you. Happy new month. We thank the Lord Almighty for the privilege of seeing this great month. Thank you, Father. Now, you are thanking him now for another reason. You are thanking him for the new month. Begin to thank the Lord for the blessing of this new month. Say, Father, thank you for this new month you've given to us. Thank you, Lord, that I can step into the month of June. Thank you for the privilege of being alive to see this month. Father, we are thanking you on behalf of our children, on behalf of our families, and on behalf of everyone who is praying with us this night. Lord, we say, may your name be lifted up. Take all the glory, take all the honor, Father, in the name of Jesus. I worship you with all my heart. Thank you, Father, for this new month of June. Thank you, Father Almighty, for this great honor, for this great privilege, for this great opportunity, Lord, for this great blessing, Lord. Seeing this month is a blessing already. So we are thanking you. We are blessing you, Lord. Receive all the glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive all the honor in the name of Jesus. Lord, you are wonderful. Lord, you are excellent. You are great. You are glorious. You are powerful, Lord. Take all the glory. Receive all praise. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Let us tell the Lord we are sorry for all ways we may have offended him. Anyway, we have offended the Lord. Let us pray for forgiveness. Forgiveness for the sins we committed in the month of May, in the month of May, all the ways we were not serious enough, or the careless acts, or the careless, or the wrong actions. Let us say, Lord, we are sorry for them. We are sorry. Pray for forgiveness on behalf of your family. Pray for forgiveness on behalf of your household. Anyone in your family that has offended God, seize this opportunity to pray for mercy upon them. Say, Lord, forgive my family for the mistakes we may have made in the past month, for the mistakes, for the wrong actions, for the wrong use of words, for the wrong places we've been to, and everything we have done wrongly. Lord, we are so sorry. We confess our sins to you, Lord. And we pray, Lord, that you forgive us, Lord. Lord, forgive us, Lord, forgive us. Cleanse us, Lord. Cast me not away from your presence. Cast me not away from your presence. For I have sinned against you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your blood be released upon my family. Let your blood cleanse me. Let your blood cleanse us right now. In the name of Jesus, I receive forgiveness on behalf of my family. I receive forgiveness on behalf of my household. On behalf of all of us, Lord, we tap into your power of forgiveness now. And we say, Lord, we are forgiven in Jesus' name. We receive the forgiveness of God now. We receive the forgiveness of God for everything we've done from the beginning of the month of May to the end of the month of May, Lord. We receive forgiveness, pray for forgiveness over the Lord, through the blood of Jesus. Through the blood of Jesus Christ, we receive forgiveness in the name of Jesus. I receive forgiveness, Lord. I receive forgiveness. I receive forgiveness, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. We are not worthy, O Lord. We are not worthy, O Lord. We are not worthy even to mention your name. We are not worthy, O Lord. We are not worthy, O Lord. We are not worthy even to mention your name. I am not worthy, O Lord. I am not worthy, O Lord. Thank you, Father, for the forgiveness in the name of Jesus Christ. And I declare that this month of June will be for us a month of favor in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that this month will favor us, Lord. Bless this month for us before we step into it. Before we start our carrying our activities in this month, Lord, bless for us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. So in this new month of May, the prayer point, the prayer we are saying at the beginning of this month, we are declaring, claiming the promise of God that the reproaches of Egypt are over. The Lord has taken away the reproaches of Egypt. The reproaches, the punishment, the attacks, the works of Egypt, the activities, the consequences of the attacks of Egypt. The Bible says that they are over. The Lord says, I have taken them away. I have taken them away. This is where we are basing the prayer point of this morning, of this month, the prayer point. And the Lord is removing, God taking away the reproach of Egypt. Can you make that a prayer in the next one minute or less? Say, Lord, take away the reproach of Egypt from my life. Reproach of Egypt, take it away from my family. Take it away from my household. The reproach of Egypt, I say, out of my life. I disconnect myself from the reproach of Egypt. I disconnect myself from any reproach coming from the kingdom of darkness. I say, no, I disconnect myself from it now. According to the word of God, it is all over. I say no to it. I reject it right now. Anything coming from the kingdom of darkness to me, to my family, I reject it now in Jesus' name. We reject it now on behalf of the people of God, Lord, together. We reject it now. Every offer from the kingdom of darkness, we say no to it now in the name of Jesus Christ. And rather, we open up ourselves to the blessings of God. We open up ourselves to what God has planned and designed for us in this new month of June. In the name of Jesus Christ, we receive whatever God has for us in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. And so this scripture is coming from Joshua chapter 5. If you have your Bible, you can turn to Joshua chapter 5, verse 9. Joshua chapter 5, verse 9, the Bible says, then the Lord said to Joshua, this day I have rolled away the reproach of Egypt from you. I have rolled away. This is all God is promising us. If I were you, I would be very happy and I would be connected with this promise of God that is given in Joshua chapter 5, verse 9. And it says, this day I have rolled away the reproach of Egypt from you. Therefore, the name of the place is called Gilgal. So the Lord says, he has rolled away the reproach of Egypt from you, from me. Father, thank you for this promise. Thank you for this promise. And I pray this promise and I declare that the reproach of Egypt is rolled away forever. It shall no longer bounce back. It shall not roll back to us. It shall not manifest. It shall not come near us anymore. The reproach of Egypt out of my life, out of my family, out of my existence, out of my destiny, I disconnect from you forever. In the name of Jesus, it's all over. I say no to the reproach of Egypt in your life. In Jesus' name we pray. Now, God brought the Israelites out of Egypt. But even after God had brought them out of Egypt, many months after God brought them out, even years after God brought them out, they were still carrying the reproach of Egypt. They were still carrying the reproach of Egypt. The consequence of living in Egypt was still following them. the symbolism of Egypt was still following them. The power, the spirit of Egypt was still following them, even after the Lord had delivered them, even after the Lord had brought them out. But they were still moving around with the spirit of Egypt. And God was not happy. God was not happy with that. They left Egypt, but Egypt did not leave them. And God was not happy with that. And that was why God decided to deal with that matter. God decided to deal with that situation. In the same way, so many of us have been delivered by God, but we are still carrying the afflictions of the devil. The affliction that the Lord has delivered us from, the powers that the Lord has delivered us from, the influences that the Lord has delivered us from, the things that the Lord has delivered us from, and we are still carrying them about. I pray for you right now in the name of Jesus. That power has no right to follow you anymore in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever the Lord has delivered you from, you be separated from it forever. As it be separated from it forever in the name of Jesus Christ. As it be separated from me in the name of Jesus Christ. Anything the Lord has set you free from, every yoke, every power, every manifestation or manipulation that the Lord has set you free from, I say you are disconnected from it forever in the name of Jesus Christ. And so, in Numbers chapter 11, verse 5, we found the people of Israel still longing to go back to Egypt. They were still longing to go back to the land of captivity. They were still longing to go back to the land of bondage. They were still longing to go back to destruction. They were still longing to go back to family death. They were longing to go back to destruction. They were longing to go back to bondage. They were longing to go back to fruitlessness. They were longing to go back to poverty. I pray for you, anything that will make you long to go back to Egypt, God remove it in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody declare upon yourself and say, I will never go back to Egypt. I will never go back. I will never go back to Egypt in the name of Jesus Christ. I will never go back to Egypt. By the power of God, I declare, we will not go back to Egypt. We will not long for Egypt. We will not long for anything that symbolizes Egypt in our lives. We will not go back to where God has delivered us from. We will not go back to the spirit that the Lord has cast away from us. We will not go back to the bondage that the Lord has broken in our lives. We will not go back to the bondage that the Lord has removed from us. We will not go back to the things that have destroyed us. We will not go back to the things that ruined us, to the things that hindered our prayer life. We will not go back in the name of Jesus. Declare it right now upon yourself. I'm not going back to Egypt. We will not go back to Egypt in the name of Jesus. We will receive the power never to return to Egypt. We will receive the power never to long for Egypt. Listen, longing for something is the beginning of going back to that thing. When you find yourself longing for something, you are on your way onto that. You long, for instance, you start having appetite, you start desiring to drink palm wine, for instance, not that it is bad, you desire to drink palm wine, for instance. Before you know it, you start looking for how to buy it. That is what hunger, that is what passion, that is what appetite does. Appetite leads you to the experience of that which you desire or you hunger for. So when you desire for something bad, when you desire for sin, you are on your way to it. But I pray now in the name of Jesus Christ that you will never go back to it in Jesus' name. We will not go back to it in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. So the Lord came to them today and said to them, the reproaches of Egypt are broken. You cannot go back to it. You cannot long for it. Either in your imagination or in manifestation, you cannot go back to Egypt. And when the Lord was saying that, what was God doing? God was giving them some promises. God was giving them some promises. One, God was breaking away the yoke of negative past. God was breaking away the yoke of the negative part, every negative part Anything that is in the past that is negative, God was disconnecting them from that negative past. That is the same thing that God is doing right now. He's breaking away the yoke of the negative past in your life. That past in your life that is negative, God is breaking that yoke in the name of Jesus Christ. That negative past can be guilt feeling for the sins that the Lord has already forgiven, that you confessed, that you still feel guilt for it. God is breaking it away now. Let that yoke be broken now forever in the name of Jesus Christ. God is breaking away the humiliation and shame that came from the past life. That humiliation of the past, that shame of the past, that situation of embarrassment in the past, God is breaking it away from your life in the name of Jesus Christ. You may have moved on, but your spirit is still connected to it. Your spirit is still connected to that experience. Your spirit is still connected to that shame of experience. Your spirit is still connected to that humiliation, to that embarrassment. But from this very moment, you receive eternal healing and be broken and be set free from it in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody say, I receive my freedom from the negative past. Every negative past in your life, let it be broken away from you in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord is setting me free from the consequences of the sins. And that's what God is doing in our lives today. He is breaking away the consequences of our sins. He's telling you that our sins that are forgiven and the consequences are taken away. He's taking away the traces of old lifestyle. God is uprooting the traces of old lifestyle. The ugly passions is disconnecting us from that. He's disconnecting us from our wrong associations, terrible associations, sinful associations. God is breaking away the link with the corrupted men, link with ungodly people. God is removing evil deposits from our lives. Every evil deposit in your life right now, I uproot it by the power of God. Let that yoke be broken now in Jesus' name. That yoke is broken, that yoke is destroyed, that yoke is uprooted now, that yoke is destroyed for your life in the name of Jesus. That evil deposit is uprooted now. I command it not to be taken away now by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. Every implantation of the devil in your life is uprooted now. That is the lifestyle, that is the negative past that the Lord is delivering you from. Now receive that deliverance. Now receive that deliverance by the mighty hand of God. Receive your freedom in Jesus' name. Begin to declare yourself free. I am free from every ungodly passion. I am free from every ungodly association. I am free from every evil link. I am free from every sinful deposit. I am free from every consequence of my mistake. I am free from the work of the devil. The Bible says, for this reason, the Son of Man was manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil. And so every work of the devil in my life, I am free from it. I receive my freedom from that yoke. I receive my freedom from that power. I receive my freedom from that oppression. I receive my freedom from that manipulation. I receive my freedom from that work of the enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. And I receive my freedom now by that power in Jesus' name. So the first thing the Lord is dealing with today is the negative past. Every past, anything that is negative, that is past in our life, that is still having control over you. Right now, as you are in the presence of God, I pray that you may receive your immediate freedom. Freedom from that power of the past that is holding you down, that is holding you to that spot, that mistake in the past that is holding you to this spot. I break that yoke now in the name of Jesus Christ. Let that yoke be broken. I say, let that power be destroyed. Let that power be destroyed. Let that yoke be broken, be destroyed forever in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray. I am free from every negative past in Jesus' name. By the power of Jesus Christ, the risen Lord, we are free. You are free, dear child of God, from that which is attacking you from your past. Sometimes the attack from the past is coming from your ancestry, from your foundation, the things that happened before you were born, the things that happen at the foundation of your family tree, your ancestry, may be the things having control over you. But I am praying right now by the power of God Almighty, every ancestral yoke over your life is broken in the name of Jesus. Every ancestral power over your life is destroyed now. They have no right, they have no control, they have no access over you in Jesus' name. The Bible says that he that is in you is greater than he that is in the world. I am praying right now by the power of Jesus that you gain victory over their manipulation, over their activities, over their works, in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Now, the Bible says in Colossians chapter 2, verses 11 to 12, Colossians chapter 2, 11 to 12 says, in him you were also circumcised with a circumcision made without hands, by putting off the body of the sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ, buried with him in baptism, in which you also were raised with him through faith in the working of God, who raised him from the dead. So because you have died with Christ, now the things of the past have no control over you, especially the negative things of the past. They have no control over you. The power of Christ has control over you now, in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody say, Jesus is the Lord of my life. He will reign over me. He will rule over me. In this month of June, I pray, the past will not control me. The past will not dominate me. The past will not conquer me. The past will not hinder me. The past will not obstruct me. The past will not destroy me. I receive the power to conquer the past. In this month of June, I conquer every spirit of the past. The Bible says, I am doing something new in your life. I receive the new things that the Lord is doing. And he says, forget about the past. I need to forget about the past in order for me to concentrate on the new thing that the Lord is doing. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I push behind me every power of the past. I push behind me every yoke of the past. I put behind me every spirit of backwardness, any negativity that came with the month of May. You are not following me into the month of June. You are not following me to the month of June. I say no to it in the name of Jesus Christ. I say no to the demon following me in the month of May. You will not follow me into June in the name of Jesus. I reject you. I reject your influence. I reject your activities. I reject your manifestation. I reject you in the name of Jesus Christ. You can't journey with me. Begin to deny them access to you. Every power of the enemy, every manipulation, every negativity, deny them access to you. Refuse to carry them along. Refuse to allow them to journey with you. Tell them, you will not journey with me to the month of June. Sickness, you will not journey with me to the month of June. Backwardness, you will not journey with me to the month of June. Indebtedness, you will not follow me to the month of June. I say, no, I drop you at this point. I drop you at this point. I can't go on. I can't go with you. I can't carry you. You satanic manipulation, you can't journey with me anymore. Anything that is negative cannot follow me, cannot follow me, cannot follow me into this new month. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. And I pray for you, child of God, that they cannot follow you. That manipulation of the enemies will not follow you. That activity of the devil will not follow you. Backwardness will not follow you. Failure will not follow you into this moment. They will not journey with you. As he said, God will never journey with you into this moment. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Because the Lord has given you the grace to begin afresh, and he says he's doing something new in your life. God is doing something new in my life. He's doing something new in my life. I receive that new thing which he is doing in my life. I receive that new thing right now by the power in the name of Jesus Christ, to pray. Now, when the Lord is telling us that the reproach of Egypt will not will not follow us or will be rolled away or has been rolled away. The second meaning of that is that he's breaking away the yoke of slavery. Remember that Egypt was a land of slavery. It was a land of bondage. The people of God were in bondage in the land of Egypt. Even when they left the land of Egypt, mentally, they were also in bondage. They had a kind of mental slavery. But God was not telling them, finally, I want to deal with this. I want to deal with this problem that has been following you. This problem that has been associated with your personality. It is time for me to deal with that problem. I want to break that bondage in your life. That addiction, that slavery that has been accompanying you. I am breaking it away right now. I am praying for you, dear child of God, now. Let every yoke of slavery be broken in your life in the name of Jesus. In this month of June, receive freedom from slavery. Freedom from slavery. Freedom from slavery. I receive freedom from slavery in the name of Jesus. Declare it unto yourself and say, I receive freedom from slavery in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive freedom from slavery, any kind of slavery, any kind of slavery. Let that yoke be broken. 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 In the name of Jesus. Slavery to sin is broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Slavery to addiction is broken. Slavery to sickness. Slavery to sickness. The power of sickness has no right over you in this moment of joy. They have no right over you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I break that slavery to poverty and hardship. Slavery to poverty and hardship. I break it. In the name of Jesus, I break slavery to fear. Slavery to fear. Are you addicted to fear? Are you a slave to fear? Let that yoke be broken now. And you can see Jesus as the power of God. That yoke of fear is broken now. And you put it for your life, for your body, for your sister. In the name of Jesus, no more shall you live in fear. No more shall you live in fear. No more shall your life be under the torment of fear. You shall not be under the control of fear. Every demon of fear operating around you, I bind them in the name of Jesus. I bind them in the name of Jesus. I bind them. This mode shall walk in boldness. You shall walk in boldness. The Bible says that the righteous are as bold as a lion. This is a mode to be bold because you will feel the presence of God. And God will confirm his presence in your life. And so you will have reason to be bold this year. This is month, this month. Beginning from this first day of this month, the last day of this month, as you will walk in boldness. The child of God will walk in boldness. You will not walk in fear. The Bible says he has not given us the spirit of fear. He has given us the spirit of boldness. Amen. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. This is your possession. This is your possession. This is month in the name of Jesus. I tap right now. The grace of boldness. The grace of boldness. The grace of boldness. The grace of victory. I will walk in victory this month. I will operate in victory this month. I will operate in victory this month. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. I bring that to you. Bondage to family death is broken, is conquered. Every bondage of family death right now by the power of God. I bring that to you now. Let that yoke be broken. You can't live in that slavery anymore. Nobody will die in your family. Nobody will die in your household. Every power of family death is cancelled in the name of Jesus. It is not your portion. It is not your portion. So it is. Say, I shall live, I shall not die. We shall live, we shall not die. My son, my family, we shall not die. My household, we shall live, we shall not die. I say, we shall live, all of us, we shall live in the name of Jesus. I give the yoke of failure. Every spirit of failure, I bring to me in the name of Jesus. Every body of failure, I call, I bring, I terminate your fruit now in the name of Jesus. Every yoke bondage of disappointment, I destroy you now in the name of Jesus. I destroy you now in the name of Jesus. We destroy the bondage of promises and fear in the name of Jesus. of the bondage of bondage to backlog, bondage to setback, bondage to hindrances. We break that yoke now. We destroy it in the name of Jesus. Anything that is a bondage in your life is hereby terminated. Terminated in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody say, I receive my freedom in Jesus' name. I receive my freedom in Jesus' name. I receive my freedom. I receive my freedom in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. And then the third point, why the Lord is giving us this promise, what it means is that it means the Lord has given you a new identity, that you are no longer the same person, but you have become a new person. The Lord has given you a new identity. The Lord has changed you. The Lord has transformed you. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17 and verse 18, it says, now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. For we all, with unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror the glory of the Lord, are being transformed. God is transforming me. Somebody say, oh Lord, transform me. Oh Lord, transform me. Transform me, transform me. I am entering this month with transformation. I am entering this month as a new person. I am entering this month, oh God, as a better person. I am entering this month as a refined person. I'm entering this month as a blessed person. I'm entering this month, oh God, as a revived person. Oh Lord, transform me. I say that we have been transformed into the same image of the glory of God, image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. So the Lord has transformed us already. That is the promise he's given to us, that I am moving to this month with transformation in the name of Jesus. That means this is my month of transformation. Transformation spiritually, transformation physically, transformation mentally, transformation financially, every dimension of my life. There is transformation in the name of Jesus. I receive this transformation. I receive it. Begin to receive it now. Declare unto yourself that we receive transformation in the name of Jesus. We are transformed by the glory of God from glory to glory. We receive that transformation right now by the mighty power of Jesus Christ, to pray. Amen. 2 Corinthians 5, 17, remember, it says that therefore, if anyone be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have come new. Everything is new. Meaning that God is doing something new. When the Lord says, I am rolling away the afflictions and the bondage of Egypt, God is telling you, I am doing something new in your life. I am doing something new in your family. So in this month of June, I am praying for something new. A new blessing, a new favor, a new manifestation, a new blessing in your life, receiving in the name of Jesus Christ, a new opportunity. This month is coming with a new opportunity, a new opportunity, a new opportunity in the name of Jesus Christ. This month is coming with a new door. A new door shall be opened for you. A new door shall be opened for you. Receive a new door in the name of Jesus Christ. Something new. The Bible says, I am doing something new. This is all things are passed away. Behold, everything is new. Even in your job, something new will happen. In your office, something new will happen. In your career, something new will happen. I say something new is going to happen. Because the Spirit of the Lord will renew everything. Everything will work for your good in the name of Jesus Christ. I am praying right now. New things will happen in your health. You will get stronger and better. You will get stronger and healthier. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. God is giving us the promise that in this new month, something new is happening. This new month is coming. This new month is coming with a new blessing, a new opportunity, a new opportunity. I declare upon you that this month, a new opportunity will meet you in the name of Jesus. A new opportunity is coming your way. I declare upon you right now, child of God, this month of June is coming with a new blessing. very solid blessing, very solid blessing, very solid opportunity, very solid opportunity. We embrace you, we embrace you, we embrace you in the name of Jesus. It is your mode of excellence, it is your mode of excellence. We will excel in the name of Jesus. As you will excel in the name of Jesus, so we declare, I will excel this mode, I will excel this mode, I will succeed this mode, I will overcome this mode. If you say that, if you say that, if you repeat it to yourself, I will make it in this mode, I will conquer in this mode, I will be victorious in this mode, I will be blessed in this mode, I will be favored in this mode. This is my mode in the name of Jesus. I take possession of this mode, I claim this mode, and I speak unto this mode. Let us give this mode the command right now. We command this mode to walk together for my good. The Bible says that all things work unto good for them that are not of God. So this mode of things will work unto good for us. All things work unto good for all the people who are following us online. Father, all things will work unto good for them in the name of Jesus. All things will work unto good for their families. All things will work unto good for them in the name of Jesus. And the church will work unto good for them. Their family will work unto good for them. Their environment will work unto good for them. You will succeed in this moment. You will excel in this moment. You will overcome in this moment. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, pray. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now you can drop your intentions. We are driving rapidly on this session. Drop your intentions. What is most, what do you want the Lord to do for you this moment? In the next 5 minutes, quickly drop your intentions as we try to wrap up this session. Drop your intentions. I am praying for you. You will be remembered. This is not a touch of. This is not a touch of. You will be remembered. People who forgot to remember you in this moment. This is moment is the moment of alert. This is the moment of solid alert. People who are owing you, they will pay. They will pay it on this first day. You will get alert. I was surprised too. In the name of Jesus, this is the moment of victory, 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 victory. The Lord will bless you with fruitfulness. This is the moment of fruitfulness. You will conceive. You will conceive this moment. We conceive this moment in the name of Jesus. That yoke of barrenness is broken. Whatever is hindering the blessing of conception by the power of God, let that obstacle be removed in the name of Jesus Christ. Financial blessing shall look for you in this month of June. Tremendous financial blessing in this month of June. Receive in the name of Jesus. Receive that financial blessing. Receive that financial favor. Receive that financial opportunity. Receive it right now. Financial favors. Financial favors. Financial favor. Financial favor. In the name of Jesus. The Lord shall remember you. 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 The glory of God will be upon your children. The glory of God will be upon your children. Healing and restoration. Healing and restoration. Healing and restoration. In the name of Jesus, I link you up to the altar of Jesus, to the altar of God. You will be blessed. Your family will be blessed. Aura protection, open doors, opportunities, breakthrough, blessings upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. I am praying right now for fruit of the womb, the blessings of the fruit of the womb upon you, the blessings of the fruit of the womb upon you. Receive in the name of Jesus. Receive in the name of Jesus. Favor of the Lord upon you. No matter how many years we have still without a child, 15 years is little. God can still do something. He is the Ancient of Days. He is older than the oldest, so he can do something. These 15 years, years is just a number. God is able to change everything because he is making things new. The Bible says in his time, he makes all things new. He's going to make you new, a new mother, a new mother. Receive it in the name of Jesus. He will make you a new father, a new mother. Receive in the name of Jesus. Financial favor will look for you. Financial favor will look for you. Your divine helper will locate you. It is your month of restoration, uncommon favor, protection. Receive in the name of Jesus. blessings and protection. Favors from the Lord. It shall be well with you. It shall be well with your family. It shall be well with your household. You shall excel in this month. You shall excel in this month. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Blessings of the fruit of the womb is looking for you. It will locate you in Jesus' name. It will locate you, it will locate you, it will locate you, it will locate you, it will locate you. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Exam success upon Ngozi. Exam success, exam success, exam success. Blessings, favor, favor, heal, healing upon your husband. The Lord is faithful and he will heal you. He will remember you. In Jesus' name, we pray. If you have dropped your intention already, just say thank you, Jesus. Say thank you, Jesus. We are about to wrap up this session. Just say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for the blessing. Thank you, Jesus, for the favor. Thank you, Jesus, for the opportunity. Thank you, Jesus, for your hand of healing. Thank you, Jesus, for manifesting your power in our lives. Thank you, Jesus, for hearing our prayers. This month of June is going to be remarkable for us. It's going to be remarkable, remarkable month, special month, special month. Father, I declare this month a special month. I declare this month a month of favor. I declare this month a month of blessing. I declare this month a month of upliftment. I declare this month a month of glory, a month of miracle, a month of testimony. I declare it, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. This is my month. I will prosper. I will succeed. I will succeed in this month. I will succeed in this month. I will testify in this month in the name of Jesus Christ. I will testify. I will testify by the power in the name of Jesus Christ. We will testify. 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 Every day of this month is blessed and consecrated in Jesus' name. May this month be blessed in Jesus' name. Somebody say, I am blessed in Jesus' name. Declare it upon yourself and say, I am blessed in Jesus' name. Say, I am blessed in Jesus' name. I am blessed in Jesus' name. We are blessed. We are blessed. Myself and my people, the people of God who are praying along with us, we are all blessed in the name of Jesus. We are all blessed in Jesus' mighty name. We pray. Amen. I cover you with the blood of Jesus Christ. I cover this month with the blood of Jesus Christ. I cover all you are going to do in this month with the blood of Jesus Christ. I cover your going out, your coming in with the blood of Jesus Christ. I cover your household with the blood of Jesus Christ. Your children with the blood of Jesus Christ. Everyone around you, I cover with the blood of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, as we see fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us, but now forever in Jesus' name. The Lord be with you. May the mighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. See you tomorrow by 9, or today, later today by 9 p.m. God bless you, and thank you for joining us. Thank you for joining us.